Cameras can capture a great deal of character in the human face, but now you're in DaVinci Resolve. The final look is coming together, and the excess of character in the forehead can be a real distraction. The footage could be taken into a program like After Effects or Mocha. Instead, let me show you how to remove blemishes and other unwanted visual elements using a powerful method hidden in DaVinci Resolve's sizing palette. Hi, my name is Paul Wittenberg, and what I'm about to demonstrate is not the standard method used in Resolve to smooth skin. Okay, Alt-F to see the node tree. Then Alt-S to add a serial node. Alt-F again to see the enhanced viewer. Then select a power window. Circle would be best. Okay, let's size this. Okay, now we have to feather it and shrink it up. Push it in there. We want to get it just around the blemish. Rotate it a little. Then get it centered a bit better. Okay, rotate it just a bit more, tighten it up. I think we're pretty good now. Then we go to the tracking palette. Okay, DaVinci Resolve has one of the best trackers in the business. We're near the end of the clip, so we'll track backwards. Off it goes. Yeah, see how well it's holding on to that spot? Take a moment to track all the way through. And there we go. Now let's preview that. See how that worked. Hit the space bar to play. Oh yeah, it's holding on to that blemish real nice. Okay, now comes the trick we've all been waiting for. We take the power window that has been tracked to the blemish. We'll look for an area in the forehead nearby that is nice and clear. Okay, now we go to the sizing palette. In the sizing palette, the secret is node sizing. All you want to do is move the area in that particular node, which is just what you can see through the power window. Now we pan and tilt and move that area over top of the blemish. All right. Now we play it forward. Just hit the L key. You can't tell that something has been covered up. You press K to stop playing. Now you see where the power window is. By highlighting it, you can see where we put it. Okay, now we want to make sure that it matches just right. So we go to gamma and lower the gamma just a bit so that it matches the area we moved it over to a bit better. Okay. Shift F so that we can have a better look. Ah, yes, very nice. Shift F again. Alt-F. Now we need to add another node to cover up that blemish, the second blemish. Alt-S. Okay. All right. Alt-F. Okay, now power window. can't see it. Oh, we have to change the tool down here to power window so that we can see it. Now, all right, move that into place, feather and size. There. Rotate it. Make sure it's in place. Tighten it up a bit. Okay, down to tracking. Track backwards. And move it back to where you started and track forwards. Okay. Preview shows it's holding tight. Okay, now we move that to another spot. Now, since each node feeds into the next node, this node can't see the first blemish, so it just sees clear skin there. All right, let's pan and tilt and push that spot over top of the second blemish. All right. Adjust the gamma, bring that down and match up the surrounding skin better. Okay. Hit the loop so that we don't go on to a different clip when we preview. And off we go. Oh yeah. You can't tell that there's two different things covering up marks on the surface. Now that we've removed the big distractions using node sizing, the idea of the forehead having characters flying right out the window. So we might as well see what it looks like with some skin smoothing. The standard method used in DaVinci Resolve starts with qualifying the skin. We go to the qualifier palette to select the forehead. Alt F to see the node tree. Alt S to add another node. Alt F again. All right, let's highlight it so that we can see what we're doing. Oops, got the wrong highlighting thing. Go to standard. Holding the mouse button down, slide the cursor over the skin until it is all selected. Okay, that's good. Now we go back to the other black and white highlighter, so we can actually see the mask that has been created. Let's denoise that a bit because of the speckles in there. Okay, Use the white clip to get rid of the black speckles in the white. Blur the radius a bit so that we have a nice soft edge. All right, now turn off the highlight. Go over to the color matching, another counterintuitive place, but hidden down in the bottom of the color matching palette is adjustments and the mid-tone detail. As you pull it down into a negative number, it lowers the mid-tone detail and smooths the skin. Let's have a closer look. The actual size, nice smooth. Now if we pull it the other way, it would actually increase the mid-tone details if we wanted to add a little character back now that we've removed the blemishes. But we don't. Negative number. Zoom to fit and preview. Ah, yeah. Great skin. Okay. Let's see the before and after. Alt D, we can see the before. Alt D again, and we see the final result. My name is Paul. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. For Star Challenge Media, thank you.